What's going on? Welcome to the fifth part in our six-part series on how to build a marketplace with no-code tools. Okay, so today we're going to be talking about Stripe, which is the tool that we're going to be using to process our payments. Now, there are going to be two main ways that we can use Stripe. One is with payment links, and then the other one, which is going to be our preferred method, is by using make.com and the Stripe API. Now, in order for you to implement some of the more advanced stuff that we're going to be talking about today, you will need to know how to set up user accounts. So you can do this either in MemberStack or inside of something like Glide that I talked about in the last video. With that being said, we've got a few things to cover in this video. First of all, we're gonna be going over what Stripe is, how it works at a high level. Then we're gonna be diving into the difference between using payment links and using the Stripe API. And then I'm gonna be talking about some commonly used business models that you see on marketplaces that you'll be able to implement, like subscription, usage-based pricing, and Connect. And I'm also gonna be showing you behind some apps to see how something like Stripe would be implemented with the API. With all that being said, we've got a lot to cover. Let's dive into the first part, which is to talk about what Stripe actually is. Okay, so let's start off with what Stripe is. Now, Stripe, like all the other tools that I've mentioned in this series, serves a very specific purpose. And the purpose that it will serve for us is to allow us to automate and streamline our payment workflows. Now, this is not something that I think you need to worry about until you really get to the point where you've got traction, where you're facilitating connections in your marketplace business. But then when you want to start automating some of the payment aspects of your business, using Stripe is an absolute no-brainer. Now, specifically for marketplaces, Stripe has a lot of fantastic solutions. So they have a tool called Stripe Connect that allows you to do multi-party payments, similar to what something like Uber or Airbnb would do, where the buyer pays your platform and then you automatically pay out your sellers. Now, instead of you having to kind of invent an entire payment system to facilitate all of that yourself, it actually just comes straight out of the box with Stripe. They also have amazing tools for subscriptions, and they've also created a whole bunch of other use cases or solutions for use cases that you commonly run into when setting up payment systems. But really, some of the things that really stands out for a lot of people is just the security that comes with using a tool like Stripe, especially as you're still in the early stages of building your business and you're kind of trying to figure out how everything goes on the job. You don't really want to be in a position where you're messing around with people's credit cards or personal details. And so Stripe just gives you that security out of the gate. They have tools for fraud prevention and just a whole bunch of additional things. Now, there are two ways that you can use Stripe. One is the purely no-code way of doing things with what's called Stripe payment links. And then the other way is using Stripe, the Stripe API. Now, the Stripe API is what we're going to be using to build out the payment system for our marketplace. However, if you just wanted to have a play around and really get going as fast as possible, you can use something called Stripe payment links, which is really the no-code version of using Stripe. So the way it works is you just create an account with them, you go and create a product and an associated price with that product, and then it will automatically generate a link for you that you can then send to people by email, or you can just paste it onto a button on your website and you can then start processing one-off payments or subscriptions. Now, with that being said, we're going to be doing some more advanced stuff, because when you want to work with portals, when you want to create things like premium subscriptions where your users will get access to certain parts of the app that others won't, then you'll need to set up something more advanced. And the way that we're going to do that is by using the Stripe API and make.com. Now, let's take as a use case, for example, Board Breakers, which is a marketplace for hiring chess coaches. And let's say that we want to give our buyers the ability to upgrade to a premium account that might give them access to more coaches or something like that. Now, the first thing that you're going to need to do is really think about all of the individual steps that are involved from a user experience perspective. And so the first thing will be that we need to make it easy for them to upgrade their account to a paid plan. And so they'd click on a button. It would take them then to a page that looks a little bit like this. They'd then fill out all of their contact details. And then as soon as the contact details and the payment information is submitted, what we would expect to happen is to receive the payment into our Stripe account. And then at the same time, to trigger a set of workflows that will then automatically upgrade the customer to a premium account, which will then give them access to other parts of the app that they won't get access to when they have a free plan. Now, unlike with the Stripe payment links, we actually have to set up custom workflows that will allow us to send information to Stripe to, for example, initiate things like a new checkout session where we want to buy a subscription. And then we also need to set up workflows for basically monitoring different events that happen inside of our Stripe account. Now, in the case of a subscription, it might be when someone subscribes to your platform for the very first time. It might be when they, you know, pay an invoice for a subscription. It might be when they upgrade or downgrade their subscription. It might be when they cancel their subscription. And the way that we do that is by firing a set of workflows from inside of make.com and then storing that information in whatever places we want. Now, the first example that I'm going to go over is how we would use make.com to initiate a checkout. Now, if we have a look at how our make.com workflow is set up, our workflow starts with a custom webhook. Now, I've talked about webhooks on this channel before. If you don't know what webhooks are, maybe just search the channel for the term webhook and you'll get a bit of an explainer. But as soon as we fire the webhook, and we'll be putting this webhook inside of our app later on, what we would do is initiate a checkout session. Now, Stripe has awesome API documentation where they talk you through the exact step-by-step process for how to configure different steps of the process. But in this particular case, what we would do is we'd make an API call to their checkout/sessions endpoint. We can then specify things like the success URL, where we, for example, determine where we want to send someone as soon as the payment has succeeded. We can also specify the actual product that has been purchased. Now, you can actually just hard code that in here, or if it's something that might be changing on a dynamic basis, you can actually pre-populate it with variables that you might receive from your webhook and so on. You can populate it with, you know, things like the customer email address so that you can be sure that the person who is paying in your Stripe account is the same person who initiated it in the app and so on. And so there are a lot of different ways that we can configure this, but as soon as we run this API call, what will happen is that Stripe will receive the information and then send us back to a page that has the checkout session. And so ultimately, that is what we're doing here. Now, if you are brand new to this and this seems super technical to you, do not worry. I was in that position myself at some point, but it actually turns out that Stripe does just a phenomenal job at explaining exactly how it works and how you can configure it. Using their documentation and then also asking ChatGPT a lot of questions will really put you in a great position where you can really configure most of the business models that you want to implement in your business. But just to kind of show you a specific example of what it is that you'd have to do for subscriptions, you'd have to go through the process of, first of all, creating a checkout session. So when someone wants to buy your subscription, then you'd go through the process of setting up a workflow for monitoring subscriptions. So seeing whether or not someone, you know, made their payment, or, you know, if they canceled their subscription, that type of stuff. Then you also want to configure a customer portal so that if, for example, a customer wants to cancel their subscription at some point, they'll be able to access it in there. And then as soon as you configure the customer portal, you'll also need to use a similar method to what I just showed you to allow them to initiate portal sessions. And so it might seem like a mouthful, but as soon as you've had a little bit of a play around with this and you kind of got the basics of how the Stripe API works, you can really do whatever it is that you want with Stripe, and you can build super flexible business models with it. Just to give you a little bit of an insight as to a workflow that I have on the Unicorn Factory. So this is one that I use to manage my subscription. So when, for example, an invoice payment is made, it triggers the workflow. So I can set this up from directly inside of Stripe. And then it goes through the process of basically, you know, adding the relevant transaction information to Airtable, which then triggers workflows that will upgrade or downgrade a freelancer that's on the platform. I also send myself Slack notifications. And if you want want to do some more advanced things with things like Google Ads, you can also send conversion events to Google Ads so that you can then optimize your Google Ads around it. But really, the way that you'll configure your different workflows is going to be very much dependent on how you are running your systems or your payment systems within your business. So ultimately, the best place to get started is to start off super simple and then build from there. Now, another very popular business model is usage-based pricing. This is, in fact, the business model that I'm currently using on the Unicorn Factory. And the way it works is that you have different products that people can buy with credits on your site. And so really the way it works is that your customers will sign up. They will then be able to buy credits. And so in this case here, we'll have say like a starter pack where they can go ahead and buy credits. Let's buy 30. What that will do is it will initiate a checkout session pretty much as I just described. And then you can just add your payment details in here. Just as a little tip, if you want to test this, just do it in your test account. You can use you can simply use the 4242 card to basically test it all. But what happens is as soon as the payment is made, I get notified about it, and that will then trigger a workflow in the background that will then go ahead and record the payment inside of my account. So you can see how it's appeared here. And now when it appears here, it also adds 30 credits to my account, and then I can go in and I can start redeeming my credits. So if I say I want to use these four, I'm just going to go in here and I'll just redeem it. You'll see how it now automatically uses four, you know, it reduces my available credits. And I've got an in-depth breakdown on how this works on my YouTube channel, so I'll leave a link to that down below where you can see how I went through the step-by-step process of setting something like this up. But if you want to implement a usage-based business model, then this is something you can do very easily and very nicely using with Stripe and something like Glide. Now, finally, another business model that is very applicable to two-sided marketplaces is the buyer and seller model. Now, the way that this works is that you have sellers and you have buyers. Now, the idea behind this particular example is that you can have buyers who can add products to your store. So in this case, it's an op shop, essentially. And then you have customers who can come in and can purchase those products. And so what happens is whenever a new product is added, it creates a Stripe product. And then when someone clicks on the buy now button, it will take them to a checkout page where they can then go ahead and make the purchase. Now, one of the things that's unique with this business model is that our platform wants to take a cut of each transaction. And so what you can do is you can use a tool called Stripe Connect to essentially break up the payment that you receive from a buyer, and you can then automatically pay out your customers with whatever percentage you agreed on. So in this particular case, I've got a list of transactions that were made through the platform. So for example, John Doe, who's one of the sellers, sold their training jacket through my site, and I have a 50% revenue share with John Doe. So that means that after the $40 are paid, I pay him out $20. And so what you can do is using the Stripe API and Stripe Connect to essentially then just automatically pay your customer that percentage out. A very popular business model, it's been used by something like by so many businesses like Uber or Airbnb and something like that. And thanks to Stripe, it's quite easy to set up. Now, I have an in-depth course on how Stripe Connects works with Make.com. You'll be able to integrate what you learn here into a member stack site. You'll be able to use Glide, the whole shebang. And basically what we do is go through the step-by-step process of setting up your Stripe Connect account. I'll show you how you can allow your sellers to create their own seller account. We'll also be going over how you can create your own little seller dashboards so that whenever someone wants to see how much money that is coming their way, they'll be able to log into their own seller account. I'll show you how the payouts work. I'll show you how to set up all of the different webhooks. And all of this is part of the MVMP labs. So if you decide that you want to do this, not just do you get access to this Stripe Connect course, you get access to the entire community, you get access to all of the other tutorials, and you get access to all of the other courses and templates and blueprints that are part of it as well. Now, finally, some action items before you go. So there are a few things that you can do in order to get started with Stripe. Now, I know that a lot of you watching this might not quite be at the stage yet where you're ready to take payments, but you can actually start having a little bit of a dabble around with Stripe by creating a test account. So when you're in your test account, you can basically create all of the different features and workflows that you would as if you have a real account, but you'll just have to use test cards in order to make it all happen. And so some real actionable things that I practice doing straight off the bat is, first of all, you know, creating payment links. So you can just jump into your test account, you can go ahead, create new payment account payment links, and then you can start seeing what that process is like that you set up, you know, where you can set up, where you can kind of like customize your checkout process. Now, as soon as you've gone through the process of understanding how all of that works, then what I recommend doing is checking out the Stripe documentation and the API and having a little bit of a play around in the developer's workbench. Now, in here, you'll be able to do a whole bunch of different things. You'll be able to generate webhooks to test different workflows. You'll be able to like monitor your events. Basically, you'll be able to do a whole bunch of fun things that will really allow you to start using tools like make.com in order to set up more advanced workflows. Another little tip that I have for working with Stripe is that, you know, when you look at this for the very first time, it might seem a little bit overwhelming and there might be too many moving pieces. However, if you jump into ChatGPT and you just tell it, hey, I want to create a subscription business with make.com and Glide, it will actually tell you somewhat accurately what the steps are involved with setting it all up and how you have to configure your make.com modules in order for it to work. Now, that is pretty much it from me. We've got one more tool to cover that we're going to be diving into soon, and it's pretty awesome. But if you have any questions about Stripe, please let me know. Other than that, I'll see you in the next video.